Hello there. Welcome to Nate's Take. Today we're going to talk about something that I get asked about just about every day, and that's how to do SEO for YouTube videos. Now, the world of SEO has changed dramatically, even just in the last few years. The strategy that I'm going to teach you right now, has four steps, is something that will last for years and years to come. I've been using it for 5 years now, very successfully, and all the different major changes that Google has made have not impacted my strategy in any negative way. In fact, it makes my strategy work better and better because it goes right in line with the goals that YouTube has, and it works really, really well, and it works long term. Once you do it, it doesn't go away. So first, I want to paint the picture of what most experts do when they're creating these YouTube videos or even blog posts or newsletters for that matter. So let's say you had a YouTube channel and you're putting out one video every single week, okay? There's 52 weeks in a year. So at the end of the year, you've got all these videos piled up, a pile of 52 videos. And what are they doing for you and your business? Which ones are being watched, okay? Which newsletters are being read, or which blog posts are being read? The ones that are the most recent, okay? When somebody creates a new video or a new blog post, they send it out to their list, they post it on social media, and it gets a spike of views because their audience loves them, they love you, they watch your video, they read your blog post, but over time, the views fizzle out because it gets buried by your new content, right? The picture that I just painted applies to 100% of the people I talk to. Well, how do we fall in that trap? Well, we do things a little bit backwards, okay? We come up with an idea for a video, we film it, we put it on YouTube and on our websites or whatever, and then we think about SEO. And that's the exact opposite. So, now let's get into things. Step number one is to do keyword research first. Before you do any script writing, before you do any outlining or whoever you're going to film it, any filming, definitely before you do any of that, you want to do your keyword research and pick the exact topic or title of your video first. Okay, I've done that for this video. Here's my screen, how to do SEO for YouTube videos. You can see that the different terms that I'm going to use as keywords for this video, which one gets the most search volume, the one that I've selected for a title. Okay, I obviously had all this ironed out before filming this video, and I do that for every single one of my videos. Unless for some reason I don't want it to get a lot of views, or if for some reason I want it to be at the bottom of that pile to never be seen again. Okay, if you follow my advice on just this one strategy, you will get results on YouTube. Even if you create crappy videos, you'll get results by following the strategy. Let me show you an example here. Okay, so check out this channel. I've shown this before because it's a funny example. All of these thumbnail images look like it's a good channel, that these videos are gonna be good, that there's gonna be this woman in the videos. She's not. It's actually a robotic voice and it's just a screen capture type video. Anyway, some of them are helpful, but I can't get through it. It just drives me crazy to watch them and listen to this robot's voice. It's worse than Siri. I actually like Siri, but I wouldn't enjoy Siri in a video, right? Okay, so the story is whoever created this channel, this guy or girl, created 115 videos. This is a year ago, and they launched these 115 videos over a span of 2 months, okay? And then they just stopped. They gave up. But then after several more months, the video started taking off. Okay, so let me show you. Let me sort the channel according to what's most popular. All right, we'll just grab the best performing video. This title is a really well keyword researched topic. People are searching for how to add background music to your YouTube videos. Okay, maybe I'll make a video on that topic. But if you come down and look at the view stats on this video, you'll see a really good curve. Okay, this is the type of curve that you want to see to know that you're getting organic search engine traffic. Once the video starts out, it's flat, and then it starts growing up and up and up, and then it's consistent upward traffic, okay? So the reason that this channel to me is so funny is the person gave up. Several months later, their video started getting traction on YouTube. Now, let me show you an example of viral videos. Now, this is what we're not talking about. This is one of my favorite channels that does have videos that occasionally go viral. It's Devin Supertramp. I'll show you the ones that are the most popular, the most viewed. In fact, the very first video that I saw of this guy was this one right here, the world's largest rope swing. They went out to Arches, Utah, and they jumped off and they went down this huge arch rope swing. All right, so if we look at the statistics on this video, you'll see the curve goes the opposite way. Okay, it starts out, it spikes up, and then it starts to taper off. Versus if you're going to go for search engine traffic, you want to have your videos ranked in the search engines and do SEO, you're going to see a different result. It's going to start out flat. I mean, if you go viral, that's great, but we're not counting on that, right? We're being strategic to make sure that whether our videos go viral or not, we're going to get a lot of views. Okay, one more example to show you is this video that Doreen and I filmed. It's on the topic of how to get rid of strep throat without antibiotics. You see here, it's got 60,000 views. Now, those 60,000 views did not come because this video went viral. In fact, it did the opposite of going viral. It started out flat. It was getting hardly any views. After a few months, it only had a couple hundred views, but then we got it ranked on the search engines. I'll even show you that. And then it's just had consistent traffic since then, about 30,000 views per year. So a year from now, it'll probably be up to 90,000 views. Let's come down here and I'll show you the statistics. I must have turned it off. It was already on before. This fancy green line here, you'll see it started out flat. And then in January of 2014, it got ranked on the front page of Google. And then ever since then, it's just had consistent growth. So that's the most important part. Number one, choosing your title. We chose the title. We did the keyword research first before she even wrote the script, before we filmed this video. Okay, so keyword research is step one. That's the most important. If all you take away from this video is that one step, it will get you leaps and bounds further with your YouTube channel and SEO than anything else, okay? Step number two is to make a really good video. Now, I'll explain how does that have to do with SEO, okay? Because you're probably thinking, well, yeah, I'm gonna make a great video. I've been making great videos, but they're not ranking on Google or YouTube. Well, if you do the keyword research part first, okay, then you make it so your video can be searchable for something, then you make a really good video. When somebody goes to Google or YouTube and they search for a topic and they find your video, let's say Google or YouTube, let's talk about them as people. So they send the searcher to your video, they're watching, okay? How much time is watched on your video, or how much time do they spend on your website? If they immediately click the back button, then Google and YouTube know that your video is not very good. But if people watch more of it, or they watch all the way to the end, or they click on links in it, they interact with it, they comment on it, they scroll down the page and read a lot more, then Google and YouTube know, wow, this is a good video. So then the next time somebody does that search, they will send them to your video again, and your video and your website will move up the ranks more and more until it gets to the top. So how do you get yours to be the very top? Well, make your video be the very best video on that topic. Make it be the most comprehensive. Make it be the most helpful. Make it entertaining. And how do you make your website, your web page, rank top? Make that web page the best web page on that topic. Let me show you an example. I mean, with Doreen here, this is her page, how to get rid of strep throat without antibiotics. It features that video at the top. It's got an opt-in box on the side that a lot of people have joined her email list because of this. And you scroll down and she's got a very thorough page on that topic, plus a very thorough infographic on that topic. So that's what we're talking about. This page we actually created a couple of years ago. Let me show you how we might design a page today. All right, so here's a page we're working on a real estate website. It's looking pretty good so far, but you see that it features a video, and you scroll down and there's just a lot of information on this topic about how you can invest in real estate without any money. So I'll keep scrolling down. Just a lot of information on this topic. Okay, we've covered three steps. Keyword research, make a great video, the best on that topic, and make a great web page, the best on that topic. If you do those three things, you'll get great SEO results, even if it takes a while. Even if you start out flat, eventually it'll take off. That's just, I can say that because that's what the purpose of Google is. That's what Google wants. They want your good quality content to rank high. Now, step number 4 will help accelerate this and help get some views to your video early on. And that is the broadcast. You want to broadcast it out to your entire email list. You want to broadcast out your video on that web page on social media. Get as much traction as you can. Do kind of guerrilla marketing. Think of any ways that you can get more people to view the video and especially get people to share it and to like it. Okay? If you know somebody else that has a list that would value watching this video, ask them, hey, do you think your audience would value watching this video? Would you mind emailing it out to them? Or hey, you know somebody that's got a real big following, loyal following on Facebook? Would you mind sharing this video on your Facebook page or, you know, tweeting it out? The more influential the person is, the more traction it can help you get early on and kind of speed up that process. If you found this video helpful, I encourage you to like it, give it a thumbs up. Also, please share it. Share it with everybody and help this video get traction on Google.